Hi everybody, my name is Maxime Chagnot. I'm a CATIA engineer working for PLM Group in Norway, and today I will show you how we can create a basic part in 3DEXPERIENCE using pad and pocket. Let's see. Okay, so today I'm going to create a basic part, and to do so I will click on plus. You can either select 3D part there or even new content. If you select a new content, you will just have more choice to select different type of element. But I will select 3D part for the moment. This pop-up menu will appear, and if you don't have it, you can click again on it and click on new content, and there you will see set attributes at creation for all type. If you do so, when you create a 3D part, then this panel will appear. So let's start. Let's make this block, okay? And we have the name of the part. This is the ID of the part, and these are unique to this part. This is PRD for product, and this will be the identification number after. Okay, so this part is block. Click on okay. And then it will create the part. And then you will select the application. So if previously I used surface design, it will open surface design. But if previously I selected part design, then I will open it on part. And then you open it part design directly. So this is our part and we have some plane. If you don't see the plane, is maybe you have the wrong view mode applied. Okay, and I will select this mode here for designer. Okay, and this one has point, axis, and wires. Great, so we have a block, and we have the essential feature. We have pad here and pocket. Pocket is great at the moment. It's because you need to have a solid first. So before we create a basic pad or solid, we will make a sketch. And I select the sketch option and select the plane I want my sketch to be, and I preferably like to have the set axis vertical. And we have plenty of different type of sketch we can create, but I will just select the rectangle. A rectangle that will have this shape. Okay, so this is a rectangle, but does not have any constraints. So we will add some values here. Distance, 100. Oops, sorry, 100. And then here, 70. Okay, now it's fully green because it is a dimension and also linked to the one in the middle. So I will exit that. And now we can make a pad. I launch the pad feature and select my sketch here. We can even see it in the spec tree here that everything is selected, and you select the length. 20 millimeter is fine for me. Click on OK, and there we have made our first feature, that is a pad. To continue now, I will make a pocket. And I can either do the same, select the sketch and select the surface or select the plane, or I can directly click on the surface here and select the contextual toolbar that proposes me a sketch. And I will do so. Now, instead of selecting a rectangle, I will select a circle that I can place like that. I can select the diameter first. 20, okay, and now my circle is black, meaning that it's not yet positioned. So we can position it based on the original of this plane here, that could work, or we could also say I want this center located at certain distance of the border. Let's say 30 millimeter from there and 40 from this one. This is more natural feeling, because this is maybe how you will measure in real life. And now we can select the pocket. Again, it will create the pocket automatically. Here you could put 20 millimeter, we could even put 10 millimeter if you want it to be half the way. Or if you want, you can just change option dimension to up to next. And this is what I will do, or up to last. Up to next, click on OK. And now we have made our second feature, the block. To finish this, I will save my part by clicking on the arrow and select save. And you will see now the block will have point A, means that this is revision A, and this is now saved in the database. So that was it for me today. Thank you very much and have a nice day.